Welcome to Uriah Heep, the Magician's Podcast. I'll be covering every studio song the band has recorded and every bonus track that I can find. Each week, we'll go over a new song from the beginning to where they are currently, and as they keep adding albums, I'll keep adding shows. Let the deep dive party begin.
In the magic garden, some were singing, some were dancing.
Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to another episode of Uriah Heep, the Magician's Podcast. This is season 2, episode 5, and we're going to be going through the song Simon the Bulletfreak. You know, it's pretty amazing. We're almost through Salisbury already. Just have a couple songs to go after this one. And man, it's just flying by so fast. But I've been getting a lot of great support from the show, support from the band. It's just been a wonderful journey so far. And a lot of you have been writing to me at the email address and just saying, that you're grateful that I'm doing the show and sharing how I got into Uriah Heep, what your favorite songs are, asking me a question here and there, some of which I know the answers to and some I don't. But keep it coming, guys, because I just love sharing my passion for this band and their music. They're a bunch of great guys and they're writing, they've written some incredible music and it's great to come together and share all of that. Now, being that it is the start of a new week, the first thing I want to do, of course, is to thank all of the supporters and especially our patrons. We have at the $3 tier, Peter Voss. Thank you, Peter. And at the $1 tier, we have the impenetrable airtight gravesite. Kind of creepy. But cool. I love that name. I'd also like to take a moment and thank my graphic artist, Scott Lazinski, who did a great job on the logo. He did both the black and the white versions that you've seen coming off of the Podbean app. And also to Audionamics, because without them, this podcast would not sound nearly as good as it does. My voice would have all kinds of extra noise and crap in it that you don't want to hear. And their product, IDC Instant Dialogue Cleaner, does an amazing job of just taking all that out with a simple twist of the dial. Now, what the code that runs behind it is insane, but just for the user interface, it's just a very simple dial. There's other controls that I don't even need. All I do is turn the dial. It's very, very easy to use. And they're great people too. I've had the pleasure of meeting them a couple times at the NAMM show, and they're just wonderful people to work with. Also, Dave White, who is Uriah Heep's webmaster. And I know he was probably laughing about my power outage my internet outage, as I had joked just, I think, the week before about him being able to post with the power outage he had from his snowstorm. We don't get a lot of snow here in Las Vegas. We had one storm last year, and it lasted just a day and a half, I think, and it was really freaky. But it happened. But I'm from back east. I'm from Michigan. Didn't grow up too far from where he's at, so I certainly understand his plight. Very important, the network of podcasts that I belong to, very honored to belong to, the Deep Dive Podcast Network, with the other shows that do music podcasts similar to this. We all have our own styles. We all have our own ways. Most of us do them by ourselves, but there's a couple that have multiple people on the show, which is a nice variety of things, and they all do a great job. First off, Nate and John at the Deep Purple Podcast, great friends, great people, great show. Even if they're just talking about whatever, I just enjoy listening to them before they even get into the song or the album that they're doing at the time. Simple Man at Skinnered Reconsidered, he does the podcast by himself, does an amazing job, has a guest host here and there. Terry T-Bone Mathley at T-Bone's Prime Cuts, his new show is coming soon, and I cannot wait to start digging into that one. Rye at Sabbath Bloody Podcast, I haven't listened to a whole lot of those. I want to get into them. There's only so much time I have, but I listened to the episode he did on Born Again, which was the only album that Ian Gillan sang on with Black Sabbath, and yeah, he's really good. He's very insightful, very knowledgeable, great show to listen to. And then, of course, the heavily accented Paul, Joe, and David at the Lap of the Pods Queen podcast. Great guys. Love listening to you. And I know almost nothing about Queen, so I've been learning a lot from them as well. And then to expand that a little bit, if you want to get into the history of live performance of the bands Emerson, Lake, and Palmer, as well as Emerson, Lake, and Powell, as well as Deep Purple, check out GottaHearEmAll.com. Great stuff there. And of course, the manager of the band, Ace, has a podcast himself on Stitcher. You can check out Ace on Music. Very insightful, a lot about the music business and how it works. He talks about how the 50th anniversary box set was put together. A lot of great information, and it's really enjoyable conversation that he and his co-hosts have. Great to listen to. So check that out on Stitcher. He's also got a YouTube channel that has some other videos on it. And I've got the links in the show notes in there for you guys. Also, very important, you can follow the podcast at scotthaskin.com and then just click that Uriah Heep link. And then also we are on Facebook at facebook.com/UriahHeepPodcast, Twitter at Heep Podcast, Instagram at Uriah Heep Podcast, and email at UriahHeepPodcast@gmail.com. I'm always willing to put the dot in there. So also thank you guys very much. Now, I want to also expand this just a little bit, this episode, because there is something else that I just looked at yesterday. And I was really excited about it, actually, because, you know, it's interesting when you think about, you know, you put something out there, you hope that you reach a lot of people, you hope you find fans of what you're talking about, you hope that new fans of what you're talking about will come along. And just looking at the statistics from the podcast, and I'm not sure where all these are collected from, if they're collected from all the different sites that the podcast comes out at, or if it's just from the app site through my distributor, which is Podbean. But here is the amazing list of countries that listen to the show. And this just blew me away. I figured it was like, you know, the United States, the United Kingdom, you know, a couple other dots here and there. But it's actually pretty incredible. So I guess the particular order would be the number of downloads for this list. But it would be the United States, the United Kingdom, who I figured would be at the top. But we've also got Canada, Germany, Norway, Australia, Sweden, the Czech Republic, the Netherlands, Finland, Ukraine, Brazil, Bulgaria, Italy, Russia, Spain, France, Singapore, I can't speak today, which is a great time to do a podcast, Japan, Switzerland, Denmark, Poland, South Africa, Hungary, Greece, Turkey, Bolivia, Belgium, Chile, Israel, Lithuania, Serbia, Slovakia, Ireland, Croatia, Georgia, not the state, but the country, Astoria, Mexico, New Zealand, Romania, Bangladesh, Faroe Islands, which I'm not familiar with. I'm going to have to figure out where that is. The Philippines, Austria, India, Kazakhstan, Malta, and 25 people in countries that we don't even know where you're at. So, wow, guys, thank you so much. That is such a stunning list of places where people listen to the show. And it's great, you know, between that and the emails and then the comments on posts, really shows me that people are enjoying what we're doing here. And that really means a lot to me. And I'm sure it means a lot to the band as well. You know, they've been of great support endorsing the podcast, and just wonderful to be doing this. So thank you guys very much. We're here today to talk about the song Simon the Bulletfreak. And now, if you recall, I'm doing these in the order of the American version of the album. I guess this was actually the last song, I think, on one of the versions of the album. But on the version that I'm used to, it was the first song on side two. There's only two songs on side two of the LP. And obviously the final song is the epic title track, which we'll be digging into tomorrow. Now, you know that most of these episodes are around, like, you know, 20 to 30 minutes long. Obviously, with two versions of a 16-minute song, there's a lot to unpack. I would expect that episode's going to be very long. I'll be recording that in my time tomorrow, which will be Saturday. For you guys, it'll be Tuesday that you're hearing it. And boy, just, you know, buckle up, get a beverage, and sit down and enjoy that one. But right now, we're going to get into Simon the Bulletfreak. Very interesting song. It's amazing how the tempos on this album are, because there are not a lot of hard driving songs on this album, yet the album really seems to move along at a good pace. And I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that the songs are so interesting. If the songs were just long passages of, you know, okay, now we're going to sing another verse and then there's a pre-chorus, the album would seem like it's an hour and a half long, but this one, it just goes so fast. If I listen to the album from start to finish, I feel like I'm done in about 15, 20 minutes. And that really is only about as how long Salisbury is. So it's really amazing at the tempos that they have, how interesting they make the songs to make them just fly by. And Simon the Bulletfreak is no different. There's some great sounds in here. And you know what? I'm just going to get into the song right now. Let's hear the beginning of Simon the Bulletfreak. Right at the beginning there, Paul Newton kicks this off on the bass guitar, and it really sounds like it's like right at the edge of clipping the meter. You're getting some fuzz coming out of that, which sounds really nice. It gives a really nice atmosphere to the opening. And then, of course, Keith Baker kicks in on the drums. This is not an organ song. This is a piano song, which is a nice change of pace for the album. And you can just hear a nice little tone being set right off the bat. You know, I really love when David Byron sings like that. He sings with such almost compassionate sounding gentleness. And I love the vibrato that he uses at the end of some of those words there. It's just the way it just trails off is really magical. And, you know, when I used to sing, I could say that that's, for me at least, it was a fairly difficult thing to do to really keep a good amount of strength as you're fading out like that. But he's a master at it. And you've got a great strong guitar presence behind this, just very, very solid, driving it, moving it forward. We're into some good stuff here. Land of hope to speak in, bring back the mood. Don't play a silly game with me. Oh, what a waste of daydream. What is your need? I'm gonna bleed until you help. There's really so much going on here. You know, you've got the piano that whenever the piano plays in this style, it really does help move things along. And then you've got this really just powerful guitar foundation. Drums are great, but then you've got Paul Newton, who's really playing a great groove here. And, you know, there's so much that's happening, so many layers that are just kind of moving the song forward to really support this vocal. You've lost all side of your direction. You're only looking for the next one to kill. What's interesting to me here is in that first part coming out of that last vocal section, the piano is very hard panned to the left ear. The guitar is over in the right ear. But then when Mick starts his solo, it flips over to the left ear. The piano gets really quiet. And then you just hear bass and drums in the right ear. So the guitar was over in the right. Now it's over in the left for the solo. It's a really abrupt change, and it's definitely an interesting sound hearing the guitar blended with the faint piano back there in that ear. But really cool. It's like the melody's over on the left, the rhythm is over on the right. But it's interesting how they change that up. Another great solo from Mick. Nothing too grandiose, nothing flashy, just really fits right in the groove of the song. And, you know, it's sometimes I look at a solo, whether it be a guitar or an organ, And I think like this just replaces the vocal, because the vocal would be here, but there isn't, so you can play the solo. So you need to keep it interesting as the vocalist would. And right here, it's just perfect. It just sits right in there covering for the vocal and doesn't try to outshine it. It just keeps the song moving along beautifully. Now, I'm going to stop the song here, Hi, Captain Obvious, but the reason is because we do have a little bit of an addition, and normally I would just, you know, let that pass, but while we have the backing vocals that come in very sweetly, there is, in the distant background of those vocals, a very high vibrato harmony that just sounds absolutely amazing. So the next time you hear this, or if you want to rewind it, pay attention to that, because it's really, really quite stunning, and it just adds yet another level to the depth of what they can do. The harmony alone would be enough, but the high harmony on top of that is just absolutely spectacular, and I love the amount of vibrato on it. It's really just perfect. Now, if you listen to the way that he sang the word today, that just kind of floated out there just for that extra emphasis, and it really worked musically to delay that one word. But that's the kind of vocal I'm talking about. I love when he does that. If he just did that all the time, it would be too much. But he just lays that in there just so perfectly with that gentleness and that vibrato. It's just amazing how well he can do that. But then, you know, leading out of the song, we've still got the groove and bass line, great drums, and Mick is going into another solo while the piano is backing him up. And I really would love to hear where this solo went, because it's starting in the direction that you've heard before in the song, but then it starts to go to an alternative of that, which I find really, really interesting. And I'd love to know what happened after the fade out. But we don't get to hear it. It does fade out, fairly quick fade out too. But very nice song, very powerful. It just goes to show another example of how much you can do with something simple. There's nothing grandiose about the song, but it does move along very well. It is a rich and full sounding song. Everybody's playing a great part, really good drum fills and a solid beat when there isn't a fill. A couple of great solos with some great rhythm guitar and piano just moving along, not trying to outshine anyone. And I really like this song, if you couldn't tell. Now, I could go on forever, but I want you guys to rest up for tomorrow's episode, because tomorrow we take on the title track, Salisbury. And that song is just a huge song. I mean, it's not just the fact that it's 16 minutes, but it's everything that it takes on and so many changes and passages. I don't have any clue how long the episode is going to be, except that it's going to be long. So I want you guys to rest up. Have a great day. Welcome to the start of your week. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you for joining me on this episode of Uriah Heep, the Magician's Podcast. If you have enjoyed this show, please consider going over to Apple Podcasts or your favorite podcast outlet, leaving a rating or a review. Be sure to subscribe to make sure that you are notified when new episodes are available. Please be sure to share this podcast with your fellow Uriah Heep enthusiasts and anyone who you think would like Uriah Heep, which should be everyone. And if you are so inclined, please feel free to contribute to the Patreon account. And if you are not a Patreon subscriber, you can also pay through the PayPal link on the website listed in the show links below. I would also like to thank Uriah Heep for their very generous support of the show, and thank you guys for listening. We'll see you in the next episode. Happy days!